8,500 underway at present.
Without interruption, 3 minutes.
Gramagat Laskian Corla Tonishta. This morning, parents across Ireland have woken up to the shocking fiasco of spiralling costs of building the National Children's Hospital. They read this morning with horror the fact that the situation has spun so far out of control that the current estimated cost has ballooned from an initial €404 million in 2012 to a mind-boggling figure of over €1 billion today. And as it stands, Ireland's National Children's Hospital, if built, will be the most expensive children's hospital to be built anywhere in the world. This infuriating saga is now a sorry tale of bungles, incompetence and broken promises stretching across 2 decades. In that time, we have seen both Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael-led governments make big announcements to the Irish people, but those same governments have delivered very little. Today, 24 years after the idea was first proposed in 1993, the National Children's Hospital is still a project wrapped in uncertainty and chaos. But Tánaiste, we should probably expect little else from a government whose entire approach to healthcare is based on fostering crises, havoc and confusion. As our health system creaks, your party has spent the last 2 weeks gazing at your own navel, indulging your obsession with who might be your new leader. Well, newsflash, Tánaiste, Fine Gael and your government is utterly bereft of any leaders. And the abject failure to get a handle on the astronomical costs of the children's hospital and to allay the fears of parents is proof positive of that fact, if further proof were needed. This week alone, Tánaiste, 1,486 patients have found themselves on trolleys in our hospitals, and this should rightly cause shock and outrage. But the truth is that having 500 people lying on trolleys on a daily basis has been normalised under your government. We've seen through recent primetime investigates the horrifying stories of children as they wait in agony for vital scoliosis surgery. And on March the 7th, nurses and hospital support workers will proceed with industrial action because of the stressful and unacceptable working conditions created by your government. So this government, through its arrogant treatment of nurses, is again putting the health and welfare of our children in grave risk. So whether it's Deputy Varadkar or Deputy Coveney or anyone else in the hot seat, ordinary people at this stage have no faith in your government to deliver a fair health service and accessible health care. Can you tell me, Tánaiste, how you stand over the outrageous and spiralling costs of the children's hospital? And can you tell us, Tánaiste, when will this hospital be built?
Tánaiste, Gramaiga, Tánaiste.
Well, there have been decades of discussion about the need for a new children's hospital in this country. And following those decades of debate and discussion, this country is about to get a much-needed new children's hospital that it badly needs and that the children in this country deserve. And, you know, what this government has done, it has ensured that a world-class design with child-friendly, high-spec, proper hospital for our children is going to be completed. More than a hospital, the new children's hospital and the satellite centres will be a research-intensive academic healthcare institution and providing the very best of care day in, day out. Now, what this government has done is ensured that a site has been selected and the works have actually begun on that site. The original estimate was £630 million, which was the core building costs of the hospital at the time. Now, we all know that there's been building inflation, and building inflation was expected to be at 3%. Everyone in this House knows that it's running at 9%. That figure did not include some of the issues which are being spoken about at present in relation to the costs. There was always going to be, for example, the IT costs that would have to be taken account of. There's also a new education and research centre as part of the development, and it has been that has now been included, and that will be funded other than from that £630 million, which was the original cost of the build. So let me say that we have moved the situation to where there is clarity about the site, where the work has actually begun, where people are on site doing those early works that are needed. And a hospital design has been agreed by everybody that is world-class. So we will have a world-class children's hospital in the next couple of years, as has been outlined. But the core estimate was when construction inflation was estimated to be at 3%. And as we know, it's running at higher than 9%, as I have said. So the updated capital costs have now been incorporated into the final project brief and submitted recently to HSE and currently under consideration. And the Minister for Health will be bringing an updated memorandum to hospital, for the hospital. And that memorandum will outline the new costs, and full details of that will be set out in the new memorandum, which will be brought forward shortly. But I think we must not lose sight of the vision for the new hospital. The new children's hospital will give us an excellent hospital, the new children's hospital. It will facilitate and care for the very many sick children in this country, and it will look after 25% of our population, because one in four of people in this country are children, and we need that hospital.
I'm sure not deliberately referred to Cabinet as hospital, and perhaps the chaos in both is comparable in recent days. The only thing that's clear here is that you continue to equivocate on the matter of costs. Are you happy, Tánaiste, that the Children's Hospital, if and when completed, will be the most expensive children's hospital built anywhere in the world? A children's hospital in Finland, a comparable jurisdiction, would have cost half what it is going to cost, it seems, here. What are you going to do, Tánaiste, about those costs? Or will government again sit on its hands and leave it to the Public Accounts Committee to call authorities to account for spiralling costs and to give an account of spending of public monies? Everybody understands the need for the Children's Hospital. This debate, as I said early on, has run since 1993. But the reality is that decades on, and there is no hospital, and now we read accounts of spiralling, outrageous and indefensible costs. So, Tánaiste, can I repeat my two questions? What about the costs? What's government going to do about this billion euro bill to the taxpayer? And secondly, when will the hospital be completed?
I've already outlined the approach in relation to the increased costs. The Minister will be bringing a memorandum to Cabinet in relation to that. The costs, there has been building inflation, which has to be taken account of course. There's also extra facilities that were not in the original plan, like the Education and Research Centre, which will be funded from elsewhere. There will also be input from philanthropy, and the government is committed to ensuring that the funding will be available. When it comes to capital costs, it's quite clear that many of our major projects have had costs overrun. You take the Terminal 2 at the airport, there was a lot of discussion about the site, about the building, about the costs. It's now there, nobody is questioning it. We absolutely need to have our children's hospital. Is anybody suggesting that we should not go ahead with our children's hospital?
When are we going to
Of course we will go ahead, and it has already begun and will be delivered in the near future, and will work according to plan that has been outlined. And as I said, this is a government that has taken a decision. This is a government that has taken a decision about the site, has provided the funding, and will continue to provide. We'll continue to provide the funding. That's a commitment.
We need our
answers.
Those aren't answers.
I have no control.
We need our answers.